so that he can clarify some of the areas and the issues that you've raised. But I want to start in this fashion. We received the mandate to discuss and negotiate with all political parties after the National Executive Committee of the ANC that was held in Cape Town indicated that we can go and discuss with any political party. And what we did as a province was to wait for the national leadership to engage a certain political party, and after every affirmation that that political party have signed to be part of the government of provincial or national unity, we then went to engage that party at the provincial level. This is very important, so that you understand how these discussions evolved. So we met with all political parties that signed at national level, which simply means we met with PA, we met with the DA, we met with the IFP, we met with the Freedom Front, we met with all those political parties that are our national leadership. Even the parties that didn't sign, but the national leadership met with them, we followed after the national leadership have met with them. That is your EFF, your MK, ACDP, Action SA. We also followed that. I'm emphasizing this point to drive something home, that at all levels we're at sync with our national leadership. And that's very, very important. Because there is a tendency to label us as rebels. There is a tendency to label us as people that are doing things outside the organizational framework. So all the negotiations, including the cancellation of the announcement of the executive twice, we did that with the cooperation, guidance, and support of the national leadership. So at no particular stage, either did we proceed or not proceed outside the guidance and the leadership of the national or our national leadership. Even the talks that deadlocked yesterday were led by our national leadership, as contained in the statement. The SG led the national leadership. They invited us to be part of the delegation, and we're part of the delegation. And when the deadlock was reached, usually we didn't reach the deadlock, as the statement of the SG indicates. When we arrived there, it said we're going to brief the national leadership, unfortunately. The other party went to make an announcement that there is a deadlock. So I'll leave the subsequent event to our SG. Mawanda, you raised the issue of the difficulties of appointing members of the Executive Council. I want to dismiss that. We don't have any challenge. We work as a collective. We've done something out of the ordinary. When the results were announced, we convened a special provincial executive committee and invited our alliance partners and our leagues to explain the new order. That we've won elections, yes, but we've not reached the 50%. And therefore, we need to engage not only with other political parties, but we can't continue to have the full executive as we used to. So that's never happened. I also took an extra measure of meeting each and every MEC that served in the Sixth administration. There was no need for me to do that. But I felt the human element is very important. Because in the absence of having the human element, it's used to divide the organization. That you are not coming back because you are either hated. They are not coming back because we are either not a member of a certain faction and other things. So I met all the MECs even before we announced today. I felt I've got that obligation as a leader to just brief all the MECs. Thanks, your term has come to an end. The numbers will decrease. Best wishes. is the situation and the outcome of the elections that find that made ourselves to be where we are. So that is not used for factional interest, or it's not used to advance certain agendas that you are alluding to. So that was that. We had the honor as well of meeting all our alliance partners, all our leagues, to also brief the Youth League, the Women's League, and brief our alliance partners of the state of affairs. So any insinuation, and I've seen it, I've heard it, that we are either controlled by a certain faction or a certain faction want to position itself to occupy strategic position within either the executive or within the PEC, I want to dispel that. It's non-existent. The figmentation of those that think they can divide us. We remain united. We are a solid force that needs to work within the ambit of the African National Congress, and we will do so. And the good thing is that we are free to express our views within the proper structures of the African National Congress. So I really feel that I need to clarify that. So we are not taking the posture that we are taking, and I'll come when I answer that question. We are not taking the posture that we are taking with our negotiating teams or those that we are negotiating purely for a selfish interest or factional interest. But the opposite is true. Every time that we negotiate with certain political parties, the emphasis is that they want to get rid of the ANC. And our posture was to defend the African National Congress. So we don't want to enter that particular space where insults are exchanged. We want to establish a government of provincial unity that will serve the citizens of Gauteng. And I can assure you, with what our national leadership is going to finalize, we are going to announce a cabinet that represents the citizens of Gauteng. And that must execute its responsibilities in that particular fashion. And that's very, very important. Mthunzi alleges that if you don't see an eye to an eye with any other political party, you must not greet them, you must not shake their hands, you must not have some talks. Unfortunately, that is in my character. That's how I was brought up. It's the selection of the people that I've greeted, exchanged sporting results that we're exchanging. You select one party, whereas I've done that with everyone. Obviously, the intentions behind it, because I don't know those intentions, I'm not going to satisfy them by responding to them. So I've greeted everyone. I always do that as a leader of government. What time are we communicating the executive, Heidi? We're communicating the executive this evening, definitely. And this time is not going to be postponed. It's definite. This evening, we'll have the executive council of Gauteng. Are you going to work with MK and EFF? We are working with everyone, and we have worked with everyone, as guided by the statement that the SGF indicated. What we are going to do, and we've done it, all the political parties that are part of the Gauteng legislature, all of them have agreed to work with us, including the DA. All of them. There's no single political party that said does not want to work with us. There's only one political party that said, which is BOSA, will relate with you based on what is on the agenda of the legislature. But Action SA, we met with them, Shemle bona bagala, ba kopile something. We said, no, it's fine, there's nothing wrong. They've requested that they be accommodated at a certain committee. We feel that we can. All political parties that we met with, they indicated where they will work with us. All of them. I think there are 8 political parties in that legislature. 11. All of them have said, we'll work with the African National Congress. We don't want to, others said, we don't want to be in the executive. We don't even want to be at the committees. We want to hold you accountable, but we will work with the ANC. But where we differ with the ANC, we'll come and register our differences with the ANC. So we will accommodate and work with all political parties that are part of that particular legislature. But primarily, and I want to underline that, primarily we are working with the formation that have signed the statement of intent to be part of government of national unity. That is the guiding tool. I think we need to emphasize that particular point, because that's where our national leadership is leading us and is working with us on those matters. I'll leave what Power FM says, that there's no one to hold accountable. What we are doing is in the interest of South Africans. Or the interest of people of Gauteng. I really believe that what the people of Gauteng have said is that we don't want an outright winner that is beyond 50%. But majority of people of Gauteng have voted for the African National Congress. It's something that must not be dismissed easily. We might have not reached 50%, but the party that received the highest vote in our province is the African National Congress. What the voters said, both parties that have reached the highest must work together, and we took the tune from our national leadership on how to constitute the provincial government in terms of a government of provincial unity. There's one thing that I really want to clear, because it's very, very important out of the deliberations that happened yesterday. This is the document that the DA gave us on the day I was elected the Premier. This document, the DA said, we are going to vote for the ANC on condition you agree to this document. And I want to read this document, because it is this document that led to where we are today. And the document says, the composition of the Gauteng Executive Council, the Premier will come from the ANC, and the allocation of MECs is as follows. 7 MECs will be allocated to the ANC and other parties, and 3 MECs will be allocated to the DA. The composition of the legislature, the speaker will come from the ANC, the deputy speaker will come from the DA, the chair of chairs will come from the DA, the deputy chair of chairs will come from the ANC. That the principle of allocation of chairperson is based on an oversight model where when a party occupies an MEC position, the same party shall not occupy the chair of the portfolio. This is the document the DA gave us, saying they are requesting for 3 portfolio positions. And that's what our SG say. We have offered that. The snag is that we said we have started on this document. Let's continue. Because this is the document that led to the election of the Premier, Speaker, and Deputy Speaker. Let's go and elect the remaining votes. Then the DA came a day later, said they are withdrawing this document. That we draw in this document, and they want us to start afresh. So when they withdrew the document, we were already at an advanced stage of consulting with other political parties. And when they came back later, maybe I've heard the story that we gave them 1, we gave them 2, when they came back later, we indicated that your withdrawal meant that we need to engage other political parties. We engaged all other political parties. We really believe we can reconfigure this to be the way it is. And that's where the dispute came. Heidi, to respond to your question, I'm not sure it's you, that we postponed it twice to give that process a chance. Because the first time we thought that everything is agreed, it's fine, there's no problem. The only problem that we needed to attend was the allocation of portfolios. But when they wanted to move to what our SG says is 5-4-1, it meant that we needed to postpone the announcement to accommodate them. We then came yesterday to ensure that we accommodate them. The SG says that they even gave the deadline of 2 o'clock and the SG will respond to that aspect. So we are ready to announce a government of Gauteng this evening. And that government of Gauteng will be an inclusive government that would include everyone that is willing to work with us, and it will include everyone that is willing to take this province forward.